introduce myself. I'm a man of wealth and taste. I've been around for a long, long year. Stole many a man's soul and faith. I was around when Jesus Christ had his moment of doubt and pain. Made damn sure the pilot washed his hands and sealed his face. Pleased to meet you. Hope you guessed my name. But what's puzzling you is the nature of my game. Stuck around St. Petersburg when I saw it was a time for a change. Killed the Tsar and his ministers. Anastasia screamed in vain. I rode a tank, held a generous rank. When the blitzkrieg raged and the finest thing. Pleased to meet you. Hope you guess my name. Oh yeah. I was puzzling you with the nature of my game. Oh yeah. I watched the glee while you kings and queens fought for 10 decades for the gods they made. I shouted out, who killed the Kennedys? Well, after all, it was you and me. Let me please introduce myself. I'm a man of wealth and taste. I lay traps for troubadours who get killed before they reach Bombay.
Welcome to Mike Montagne on Mathematically Perfected Economy and Absolute Consensual Representation. I am Mike Montagne, original 1968 architect of Mathematically Perfected Economy, founder of People for Mathematically Perfected Economy, and of course, principal author of our worldwide mandate for Mathematically Perfected Economy and Absolute Consensual Representation. This program pertains to a vital thesis originally comprising mathematic proofs that any purported economy subject to interest inevitably terminates itself under fatal, artificial sums of insoluble debt, and that there is one and one only integral solution for the category faults of the pretended economies which have been imposed upon the world. A singular solution which, for over 35 years, we have called Mathematically Perfected Economy. Over 40 years of advocating the fact of inevitable failure and singular solution, every United States president since and including Gerald Ford has been presented a proposition of mathematically perfected economy. In 1983 and 4, I provided the Reagan administration with computer models which were and remain capable of calculating the maximum possible lifespan of any pretended economy subject to the obfuscations of what we call a central banking system. These original models, complete with source code, remain available from descended work at People for Mathematically Perfected Economy, perfectedeconomy.org. And of course, we can run the same data in these models today to replicate their vital projections. Nonetheless, then, in 1983 and 4, these original models projected from early 1980s data that the present monetary failure would transpire at approximately 2010 AD as a consequence of an obfuscation of our currency, which can only multiply artificial indebtedness in proportion to remaining capacity to service debt. As this said disparity, of course, inevitably manifests in the present failure, it is this process and its resultant injustices which we must understand if a people who make themselves capable of responsible self-rule are to avert failure by uniting over fact of singular solution. My vastly plagiarized work, therefore, explained over 40 years ago not only how the present failure would transpire, but exactly how to solve and to avert the present consequences. Some 15 years later, in 1984, together with exhaustive documentation of this original thesis, all this comprised the first and since most plagiarized online monetary reform presence, some 10 years before the official 1993 and 4 inception of today's internet. While this work is now perhaps the most plagiarized monetary thesis in history, even its original forms disproved every recent pretended contending proposition of solution over 40 years ago. For from its very inception, mathematically perfected economy was a proof of singular solution. That is, from its inception, mathematically perfected economy was a proof that nothing else solves the categoric faults of pretended economy, and that nothing else solves the fundamental causes of the present artificial failure. The following is the seventh of a set of introductory discussions which are best negotiated in order, as previous material develops a vital background for what follows. Links to archives of this and previous programs are available at tnsradio.com and through the domain perfectedeconomy.org. Respondents can sign national instances of our worldwide mandate for mathematically perfected economy and absolute consensual representation at perfectedeconomy.org. This program is broadcast regularly at 3 p.m. Pacific time, generally to at least 6 p.m. each Saturday, today on December 4th, 2010, from TNS Radio, tnsradio.com. Tir Nassar, Land of the Free. Original material copyright and trademarked by Mike Montagne. All rights reserved. Preceding programs address facts that the purported banking systems which have been imposed upon the world are not true creditors, that they give up no property for promissory obligations, that even under virtually any contractual system of law in the world, and certainly with respect to any reasonable, accountable system of logic, no commensurable debt therefore can exist to them, as there is no lawful consideration. On the contrary, the purported banking systems which have been imposed upon the world merely pretend to issue credit. Rather, they intervene upon our commerce to merely publish evidence of our promissory obligations to each other, what we call money. That in turn, for the mere negligible cost of publication, their first stupendous crime against us is that they launder all the principal which is ever created in this way into their unrightful possession. And that in turn, they impose interest under a further falsification, only merely as if interest were justified by these mere negligible costs of publishing evidence of our promissory obligations to each other, which mere negligible costs are generally always recouped in just a tiny fraction of just the first usual payment against any resultant purported debt. That in turn, even as we are the real creditors, because it is strictly we who give up property for our promissory obligations to each other, their purposed obfuscation of the promissory obligation itself disqualifies the purported principle of interest, as it denies every real creditor interest. We do not, therefore, borrow money from banks. On the contrary, banks intervene upon our commerce merely to publish evidence of our promissory obligations to each other. And in fact, on the contrary, the very nature of a promissory obligation, which pays the real creditor in full from the outset of any transaction, is an obligation to maintain the integrity of the obligation and resultant currency by instead retiring principal from circulation. Under mathematically perfected economy, an obligatory schedule of payment retires the principal at the rate of consumption or depreciation of the related property. Solving all the categoric faults of the pretended economies which have been imposed upon us under the purposed obfuscations of the global central banking systems of the present world. Thus, to launder principal into the unrightful and ever unjustified possession of the purported central banking systems of the world itself makes it impossible for the indispensable life cycles of both money and property to be properly represented, because the principle persists in existence. And this laundering of principle into the unrightful and ever unjustified possession of the central banking systems of the world is itself a truly monumental, stupendous crime against us. For it is to take from us to the extent of all that we ever produce and purportedly finance under this lie of economy. Far worse, nonetheless, are the ramifications of this ever unwarranted and unjustifiable imposition of interest. Because interest implicitly obligates us to maintain a vital circulation, as we pay interest and principal out of a general circulation, comprised itself of no more than some remaining principal. This disparity, the fact more must be paid out of circulation than ever exists in circulation, in fact far more, forces us to maintain a vital circulation by the only means available under this purposed obfuscation of the promissory obligation, to maintain a vital circulation. We must, therefore, borrow back into circulation the principal and interest we pay out of the general circulation in the way of servicing any initial sum of artificial debt. The principal we must borrow back into circulation to maintain a vital circulation therefore sustains any former sum of artificial indebtedness, making it mathematically impossible to pay down any former sum of debt. The interest we must borrow back into circulation to maintain a vital circulation, however, increases the sum of debt, therefore, by so much as periodic interest on an ever-escalating sum of debt, until, at an inherently escalating rate of ever greater increments of periodic interest on an ever greater sum of artificial debt, we succumb to terminal sums of artificial